Welcome to TrainSim World 2, an immersive and highly detailed rail simulation featuring authentic routes and trains from around the world. You've just been awarded some action points. These are displayed in the top right corner of the screen and count towards your overall experience. It is necessary to be fully observant of the surrounding world. Practice by looking up, down, left, and right. This is one of many interactives to be discovered, but not all of them will be as easy to find as this one. A lot of time will be spent operating trains, so when ready, sit in the driver's seat. You can pause the experience at any point and review previous and current objectives. Check it out now and then return to the game when ready. A heads-up display has appeared on the right-hand side of the screen. This is a guide to what the train is doing. This is the speed display. The white needle shows current speed, and the red marker indicates the maximum permitted speed. This is the direction display. An arrow will indicate forward, reverse, and neutral directions. This is the power display. A number will indicate what position the power control is in. These are the brake indicators. They show the state of the various brake systems, allowing independent management of them. In the top right are the signal and speed limit displays. These feature an indication of what is approaching and a countdown distance to when they will come into effect. Some of these displays can be hidden via the settings menu for a more challenging experience. Glasgow Central is one of the major railway termini in Scotland, servicing commuter trains running around the Cathcart Circle Line and connecting the surrounding areas of Neilston and Newton. This particular train is a Class 314 electric multiple unit and consists of a pair of three-car units. It's capable of travelling at a top speed of 70 miles per hour. TrainSim World 2 allows you to ride and drive from a selection of camera views. Let's take a look now while exploring this train. You've only explored a small area here, so let's take a look at what else there is to enjoy. Welcome to Glasgow, Scotland's largest city with a rich history of shipbuilding, manufacturing, art and culture. Here you can experience the hustle and bustle of a modern suburban network using classic electric traction, which links Glasgow's suburbs with the historic Glasgow Central Hub. Along the way, be sure to apply tourist posters, refill newspaper stands, place route maps, and refill planters. Ferry commuters around the busy Circle Line and to and from Newton and Neilston. Welcome to the Cathcart Circle Line. Welcome to Driver Training. Today you'll be taken through the operation of a Class 314 electric multiple unit in ScotRail livery. During this brief introduction, we'll go through the critical driving controls and passenger operations. When you're ready, climb aboard to get started. Take a seat in the driver's position. This is where you'll be spending most of your time. To activate the control desk, insert the master key. The reverser determines the direction of travel. This train is now ready to depart. Use the throttle to apply power and get moving. Coasting is a method used to efficiently maintain speed and reduce motor stress and maintenance requirements. Keeping to speed limits is important. If you begin overspeeding, apply a small amount of brake by moving the train brake. We're now going to perform a test of the emergency braking system. Put the train brake into emergency. The emergency brake has been applied and the train will need to be recovered before continuing. Great work. Now let's get moving again. Nice job. We can now continue the journey to Glasgow Central. You're now approaching Glasgow Central. Use the train brake to apply braking force and slow the train down. Take a quick glance of the platform to ensure all is safe before unlocking the doors. To travel out of Glasgow Central, we'll have to change ends. Let's do this now while the passengers are boarding. With this cab shut down, head to the other end of the train and bring it into operation.
If you require assistance at any time, feel free to contact a member of station staff or use a help point.
Thank you.
Now we've changed ends and completed our passenger boarding, set the doors to locked. Proceed to the next stop at Pollock Shields West, unguided this time, and see how you get on. Good work. That concludes all the basics of operating this train.